He drives a red car, loves opera and solves crime in Oxford, but don't call him Inspector Morse.
Morse is marvellous fantasy, but the reality is very different.
DCI Reed is preoccupied with the ways of criminals.
He must be pretty glad getting robbed, but that's what I do for a living.
And how to stop them.
Using informers is a very dirty business.
If anyone found out what I was doing, I'll know for a fact I'll be found in a ditch tomorrow morning.
The Battle Against Crime, The Force, Wednesday at 9:50 on BBC Two.
Winter Olympics, snooker and cricket. Three great sports coming soon on one channel, BBC Two.
A little late night weather break now on BBC Two as we join Peter Cockcroft.
Hello again. You'd expect it to be pretty cold at this time of year in the Arctic, but not quite as cold as this. Some really exceptionally cold weather in Spitsbergen, Allsvallbad. Early Sunday morning, the temperature down to minus 30. Not quite as low as it's been in recent weeks, a minus 31, setting a new record there. Now, that cold air is actually going to come south, and I think during Tuesday and Wednesday, we're going to find these exceptionally cold conditions spilling across Scandinavia. We're also expecting some pretty strong winds and quite a bit of snow. It's an area of low pressure that'll be racing across from Iceland, developing, and then as it moves across into northern Russia, well, you can see all these isobars dragging that really cold air down from the Arctic Circle. So some really nasty conditions developing during Monday and Tuesday across much of Scandinavia. That heavy snowfall being driven on by those gale force winds, so blizzards in many areas. That has been quite a bit of snow to the south of the Alps as well over the weekend in Turin. Sunday afternoon, the temperature 2 degrees below freezing with 10 centimetres or 4 inches of snow on the ground there. Somewhat brighter skies though as we go into Monday. Still some thunderstorms rumbling away across the Mediterranean. That wintry weather, a really nasty wintry weather, as I said before, getting into Scandinavia, and settled conditions across the British Isles, all courtesy of this area of high pressure. Now, that means it is going to be very cold tonight in parts of Argyll in Scotland. Temperatures could be as low as minus 6 Celsius. The high pressure gradually shifting its centre a little bit further south through the next 24 hours, and that's going to be fairly significant as far as winds are concerned. We are going to find the wind chill easing across central parts of England, but still quite a marked effect along the English Channel. And as you can see there, we are expecting some rather choppy sea conditions, and although temperatures will be up around about 4 or 5 Celsius, it'll feel like more like something between minus 3 and minus 6 degrees, rather like it has done on Sunday. So I think that's where it will feel coldest, but up in the Highlands of Scotland, I think probably in some of those sheltered glens, temperatures finding a bit difficult to struggle above freezing. A lot of fine and dry weather once again, a bit of sunshine around Irish sea coast. Thicker cloud coming into the northwest, bringing a little bit of rain there, perhaps even a bit of sleet over the higher parts of Shetland. Always a chance of a few light wintry showers filtering onto some of those North Sea coasts, but generally a dry day. More frost to come during Monday night, Tuesday night, Wednesday night and Thursday night, the high pressure staying with us. But a weak weather front will move southwards during Tuesday and Wednesday, and that's going to bring some outbreaks of rain, a little bit of sleet and snow to Scotland, Northern Ireland, eventually Northern England on Tuesday, and that'll continue to move southwards, weakening during Wednesday, and then the high pressure starts to assert itself once again for the end of the week. So a pretty cold week ahead of us, but that's it from me for now. Good night.
Well, this is the point at which BBC Two is going to take a break, returning at 2 a.m. for a full night of programmes from BBC Learning Zone.